What's going on, guys? My name is Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to show you how you can make your current slides look a lot better in just a short period of time. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see here, I have an example of a construction roadmap and then some subtitle text and then three steps. Step one, ideation. Step two, planning. And then step three, execution. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to try to make it look like this slide here. And I'm gonna show you guys how I went through this process of coming up with this idea. Because I know a lot of times when you start off with this slide, it can be a little confusing as to how you can even make it look a lot better than it already is with that blank white background. So my first thought process when redesigning a slide is I need to have good imagery. So the first thing I do is I go to unsplash.com, look for a nice image that I can use for the background. So that's what I'm gonna do right here. So I'm on unsplash.com and I typed in work because I wanna find something around construction working. I could even type in construction here as well. But for this example, I just typed in work. I stumbled across this image. I really liked how the flames are coming out, it's welding, it looks really cool. So I think you can really make that slide pop. So in order to actually take this image, what I can do is I can just click on the down arrow here. It downloads right here, can drag it, hover over your PowerPoint application, and then it's gonna drop in. Another cool thing about PowerPoint that they recently have been doing is providing these design ideas for you. So this is a very quick way to spice up your slide if you're not wanting to take a bunch of time putting in the effort as to how to redesign your slides. And some of these are actually really good. So I recommend exploring these if you like to take that route instead. But for this example in particular, I'm going to be showing you how I go about my thought process in redesigning a slide. So I'm not going to use the design ideas today. All right. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this picture, delete it, go to view, SlideMaster, paste it in, and then I'm going to try to line it up to the edges like so. So that side's lined up. I'm going to line up this one. And then I'm going to actually crop it so that it fits the slide perfectly. So I'm going to hold down control and now actually crop the top and bottom at the same time. All right, so now you can still see there's still some white space that I need to fill up. So I'm gonna go back to crop and fill that up. And then I can do the bottom as well. All right, so now we're good on the image and placing it in the slide. All right, so next what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna actually insert a rectangle on top of it. And you'll see why in just a second. So I'm gonna insert this rectangle. All right, right click it, format shape. And I'm gonna choose this color here. Make it just a tad bit transparent. Can do like 23, exit out, close out. And now we have this darker visual imagery behind it. So another thing I recommend when choosing the right color for that rectangle is if you go back to SlideMaster, click on that rectangle, shorten it a little bit. What I do is I usually right click, format shape, go here, eyedropper, pick a color that's a little darker on the image. And then that's how you can find the right image color for the shape and then just make it transparent. So that's how I found that color originally. All right, so now I'm gonna close out and now I have a dark background visual. So now what I'm gonna do next is I'm actually gonna make all this text white. All right, so now I have my text white and I can see it a little bit better. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually change the font of this text. So I'm gonna change it to be Latto. I really like using Latto just cause it's nice and clean. And there's a lot of different weight sizes to it, so it's fun to work around with. All right, so I'm gonna choose Latto black and then hold down control just to make the text box a little bit smaller. And then I'm gonna change this to just Latto regular. All right, and then I'm also gonna do control shift less than sign to decrease the size of the subtitle text. So that's looking nice. What I had here for this one is I had it a little bit bigger. And for this one, I had it a little bit bigger as well. So I'm just gonna actually copy in this one because I like this one a little bit better. All right, for this one I had size 48 and then size 18. All right, so now for the steps and how to make those look nicer. So obviously, you could stick with the bullet points. It's not always the worst thing to have bullet points in a PowerPoint slide. I know everyone has different opinions about bullet points in slides. You can use them, they work well sometimes, but for this scenario, I wanna try to avoid them and keep it as visual as possible. So I'm gonna try to figure out a way to add some imagery to this. So I'm gonna shift this text down a little bit. And then as you see here, what I did was I have three circles and then some icons. So in order to create that, what you can do here is you can go to insert, shapes, circle, insert the circle and hold down shift as you're doing this. And if you don't, it's gonna be all wonky and not proportionate. So you're gonna wanna make sure you go to insert, shapes, circle, hold down shift. There we go. So now we have a blue circle. We can change the circle to be a different color. I'm actually gonna make this black. All right, and then a little transparent. And then I'm gonna change the line to be white just so it pops a little bit and change the thickness to be 4.25. So that's looking kind of nice. I can even make this even a little bit more transparent if I want. Now, what I have to do is actually I have to find icons for each one of these steps. So I have one for ideation, one for planning, and one for execution. So what I did First was I went to actually the nounproject.com, typed in idea, found an icon for that, and then I just click on SVG and it'll download. Another way to do this is, let's say you want a different icon, you can click here, get this icon, basic download, continue, do SVG, because SVGs are a lot higher quality and you can scale them without losing quality. PNGs, they work fine, they're transparent backgrounds, but as you scale them, they can look a little bit more blurry, so that's why I recommend SVGs always. And you can manipulate SVGs with the coloring and shadows and everything in PowerPoint, so they work really well. Alright, so if I do like this icon, I can go down here to SVG, it'll download right here, click and hold it, and then hover over your PowerPoint application. You won't be able to see mine because it's hidden, but I'm hovering over my PowerPoint application, it appears, then let go and drop it in. Alright, so now you have your icon here. And then if you are wondering how to make any icon editable, I do have a video that explains the whole process, but for this one, I'm just going to show you guys quickly. So what you can do is, you can right click, group, ungroup, say yes. Right click one more time, group, ungroup, and then regroup it by doing Control G, and then I'm just going to change the color to be white. So now this is what my icon looks really cool. I'm actually going to stick with this light bulb icon here, so I'm going to copy and paste it in. So now that looks really good. I still have this text here just for reference. I'm not actually going to keep it like this. And now what I need to do is I need to create two more circles and get two more icons. So what I can do quickly is hold down Control and then click and drag to create another circle. And then I can do the same thing to get one more. All right, so now I have two more circles. And then all I have to do is search on the Noun Project to find those two other icons. Since I already found them here, I'm just going to copy and paste this entire visual just for time's sake. And then I'm going to replace it with these three circles. So now I have my three circles. All the circle was a black fill with 63% transparency. And then all I had for the border was the color white with a width of 4.25. All right, and then what I also did was for these icons, I added them in and made sure they were centered with the image. All right, so next what you're gonna wanna do is, and this isn't required, but what I like to do is, just to make things easier, I'm gonna group each one of these circles so that they're one entire shape as themselves. For the next step is, I'm gonna actually insert a white line in between them just to show the flow from point A to point B to point C. Obviously this is not required, but I'm gonna just show you guys for visual sake. So you can go to insert, shapes, line, then go here, click and drag, hold down shift while you're doing that, increase the weight, make it white. I'm actually gonna make this 4.25 as the width as well. Now, in order to create a second one, I'm just going to hold down Control and then click. And there we go. Now we have both of them there. All right. So for the last part, all we need is to add text underneath each one of those icons. So what I did was I just shifted this text over, actually copied this text, brought it down here, typed in ideation, Control A, and then Control Shift less than sign to decrease the size of it a little bit, center it up, make it justified in the center. And then what I did was I actually copied in this text, enter, paste, and then I chose keep sourcing, so it keeps that size of text, decrease the size of it a little bit, and then just justify this in the center. And there we go. Now we have the text underneath the icon, and if we want to make this even quicker, we can just control and copy this, and then just change the title text to be planning, and then we can change this one to be execution. And then there we have it. So I'm actually going to paste in this one because I wanna show you guys what I did in terms of styling for this one. This also looks great. Don't get me wrong, this looks great too. But I'm just gonna show you guys just to be consistent with the other visual. So what I did here. All right, so for this one, I had a font size of 24 and then a font size of 14. And this was Latte Black, and this is Latte Regular. All right, so that is how you can redesign a slide in just a quick amount of time. It doesn't take too long to make a visual look nice. Really focus on the imagery. That's the biggest part of this lesson, is making sure your imagery is good. You can find a lot of great free imagery through unsplash.com. So if you did find this helpful and it might help you guys in redesigning your slides, make sure to give this a thumbs up. Also, if you could subscribe to this channel, I would greatly appreciate the support. As a thank you for making it this far, I also want to give you guys a 90% off discount to my course on Udemy that covers all the best tools and features in PowerPoint. So if you are interested, feel free to check out the links in the description below for that. Thanks once again for making it this far in the video, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thanks.